their full potential. And I'm not sure if we will be there when that day comes, but I believe that we have been planted there. The Bible says some plant, some water, and then God gives the increase. Well, we've been planted, and everyone in here, you are the water. And we're looking for you to help water the seeds that God has used us to plant, and then allow him to give the increase. We offer our after-school program, job readiness, life coaching, summer food program, and a clothing closet so that they can come and access the things that they need. I will not read all of them, but these are some of the programs. But WDM is bigger than program. It's an idea. It is an idea birthed in a dream. I am reminded of Steve Jobs, when he first came on the scene and he was making a presentation similar to this one day, and he walked in and he had this contraption on a piece of wood with all these wires protruding out. Him and Steve Wozniak, and they had another piece of wood with some little buttons on it. And he essentially said, embrace Apple and embrace your future. And people saw this contraption with all these wires protruding out. They heard what he said, and they could never imagine that that would ever be possible. Well, Steve is gone now, but his legacy lives on, and his idea has changed our lives. We couldn't even be here today to do a PowerPoint presentation in so many ways if it wasn't for an idea. Not what they saw, not what they heard, but an idea that was embraced. Our action plan, we can talk about the impact of 3,500 meals, but I'm more concerned about the human impact. These are just byproducts of an idea that we contribute in some small way. Thanksgiving for 80 families, Christmas toys, after-school snacks, et cetera, et cetera. Our goal is to expand. We are in a small apartment complex, in a small unit that we converted. It's not what you see. It's not what you hear. And don't let it be colored by your experiences. But this is what God can do in 2 years. We want to become an affiliate member of Atlanta Community Ministries. We are currently in process now of being evaluated for that. That's one of our long-term goals. We want to increase our literacy program because we know, again, that there is high incidence of poverty, and come with, along with poverty comes poor education. A lot of that is socioeconomic. We want to increase our fundraising efforts, and we want to be able to offer some hard skills. We want to be at some point to be able to include a vocational component so that we can span, that we can train, and that we can get people out of poverty. We want to be able to be that bridge from hopelessness to empowerment. And the only way we can do that is with your help. We want to provide financial emergency services, and we want to be able to bring in a part-time administrator to assist my wife, who's there on a day-to-day basis. Some of our current challenges is, of course, program cost sustainability. For the last couple of years, my wife and I have funded WDM out of pocket. And we know, at least I believe, that when you're approaching funders or potential funders, they want to see how serious you are about what you're doing. And the only way they measure that is by what you're willing to put into it. If you're vested in it, then there's a strong possibility then they will invest in you. And so we've been funding it by the grace of God for the last couple of years out of pocket. It's a challenge. We have a high family turnover rate because this is a low-income community. A lot of people know it's generational poverty, it's generational welfare. So they can't meet their daily expenses, they can't pay their rent, and so there's a constant influx of people coming and going. We want to increase our number of volunteers and our tutors because we know with volunteers we can expand our outreach, we can touch more families, we can expand our service delivery. And essentially, we need tutors who can help these kids to grow and to be the best that God wants them to be. And so we need tutors. And again, we want to expand our service delivery. And the only way we can do that is by establishing a capital campaign to get bigger space, to branch out so that we can touch more families, so that we can provide more meals, so that we can provide more Thanksgiving baskets and prepare people for the new world, the new economy. This economy is shifting daily. It's more service related, so we need people who can have not only hard skills but soft skills. They need to be able to provide a service, they need to be able to have some type of skill set. And so our action plan is to raise enough money to have an emergency assistance program. And this is a result of an experience that my wife and I just went through at the ministry a couple months ago. One of our families, they lost their mom. They were low income, uneducated. Both mom and dad working minimum wage. The mom died unexpectedly. They left a 9-year-old, 11-year-old, and a 14-year-old. The dad is a day laborer, more or less. And they didn't have the resources to bury the mom. And we wasn't in a position to really help them the way I would want it to help them. I wanted to be able to write them a check with no strings attached, just to show that we are here for you. We are a resource. We are commanded, as Deuteronomy 15 and 11 say, that the poor and the needy will be with you always, and that we need to open up our hand and reach out to them. And we wasn't able to do that. And so that's why we need an emergency assistance program. The $15,000 for the audio reference library, because one of the things that we noticed was that the kids were failing. Their CRTC scores were low, and a lot of them were reading at the third and below grade level. And so we believe that sometimes people learn differently. Some people are visual learners, some people are audio learners. And so if we can establish an audio reference library, that we'll be able to at least give them some tools that these kids will be able to grow and be productive in school. And finally, the $40,000 is for training support, so that we can give them those hard and soft skills, so that we can start establishing relationship with stakeholders and partners who can offer training at a low cost or at an affordable rate. And so, finally, like Steve, I ask you guys to remember that someone said something to you as a child. I'm going to pretend I'm Steve and say, instead of embrace Apple, embrace a child and embrace your future. Not by what you see, not by what you heard, and not by your color experiences. Thank you. We couldn't have done it without you. We couldn't have done it without the resources and relationships that one you have with one of our board members. And this has been a great experience for WDN. Thank you. And we're here always. Appreciate it.